Thank you, Speaker Ma'am. Thank you, Speaker Ma'am, for giving me this opportunity to speak on the very important issue of mob lynching and mob violence, which is happening in India, Madam. India is a truly democratic country with secularism and tolerism as the backbone of India. Though time and again secular values have been emphasized, Madam, it is very unfortunate that emotions are raising high on many issues of religionism and discrimination and personal ideologies and beliefs, Madam, and people are trying to take law into their hands and impose punishments sometimes which are leading to killings, Madam. India is a country of various diversities and people compete on economic issues, Madam, and political clout and on showcasing their own cultural values. We are looked upon as the world's largest democracy and we are applauded for our unity in diversity, Madam. But unfortunately, in the recent research by India, India Speed conclude that in the first 6 months of 2017, Madam, 20 cow terror attacks were reported, more than 75% in 2016 figure, Madam, which was the worst year for such violence since 2010, Madam. This is not the first time this violence is reported, Madam. They are happening for the past 10 years and is increasing rapidly, Madam. So, and these attacks include mob lynching, murder attempts, harassment, assault, and sometimes which result in gang rape, Madam. In two attacks, the victims were chained, stripped, and also beaten up, Madam. It is very unfortunate and alarming that with the rise of such unconstitutional groups which are subject to mob lynching, we are all being blamed in the world, Madam. These offenders are behaving like extrajudicial authorities, punishing the citizens and infringing the basic fundamental rights of the citizens and trying to enforce their personal beliefs on the people forcefully, Madam. Recently, I would like to draw the attention of this House, Madam, to a recent incident that happened in Andhra Pradesh, Madam. We have witnessed a very big incident of Garagaparru, Madam, Garagaparru incident which happened in Andhra Pradesh, which is a very ongoing issue as on today, Madam. A huge mob, Dalits, Madam, they were attacked for erecting a statue of Ambedkar statue in that village, Madam, and they were being subject to confinement and they were not given food and water and they were boycotted, Madam, okay. And the police were standing at each house, two people were standing, Madam, and they were subject to a lot of harassment, Madam. Okay. Now their demand is that separate gram panchayats, because as my colleagues have rightly said, Madam, Dalits are being put at the end of the villages, they are deprived of all the facilities and they are not being allowed to enter the temples of worship as well as even for the basic amenities, water is also not given, Madam. So they are demanding different gram panchayats for the Dalits so that they will also develop leadership qualities among themselves, improve on their infrastructure, educational facilities, and also become a leaders for the future generation, and also help their people, Madam. This incident reveals that there is a clear-cut discrimination, Madam, and it needs to be resolved suitably, and there should be a mechanism to evolve permanent solutions, Madam. It is not the temporary relief.
Okay.
The offenders need to be punished strictly. Just 1 minute, Madam. It is indeed, Madam, it is a responsibility on all of us to combinedly raise to the occasion, Madam. There is no blame game this side or that side. And as Satpathiji rightly said, Madam, none of us here are permanently sitting at one place, nor are permanent here. And we should all rise together to actually fight this menace, Madam. It is important that there should be no blame game. Our Honorable Prime Minister has also said, Madam, this intolerance or they have condemned the attacks of the cattle traders, beef eaters and dairy farmers, saying that killing people in the name of protecting cows or religious fanatism is unacceptable. Last point, Madam, I would just like to raise. Hence, under the given circumstances, Madam, the current violence happening in the country, I urge the government, Madam, to take stringent actions and thereby uphold the values as mentioned in the preamble of the Constitution, sovereign, socialistic, secular, democratic republic, Madam. Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Madam.
Supriya Sule.